prophet, Isaiah chapter 9, I'm reading from verse 6. And he says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called," let's be counting, "Wonderful, 2, Counselor, 3, the Mighty God, 4, the Everlasting Father, 5, the Prince of Peace." Praise the living God. And how many names do we have there? And please, let us go to the spelling of our Lord Jesus Christ again. It starts from J-E-S-U-S. Praise the living God. Now, the name of Christ, we have 5 letters in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the name that God said that this man shall be called have 5 different names. And going to the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17, and when David was about to confront Goliath, he picked up how many stones? 5. Praise the living God. He picked up 5 stones. I want you to have your own 5 stones. Amen. Praise the living God. Amen. Tell your brother or your sister, pick your 5 stones.
Pick your 5 stones.
Turn to the other side and still remind the other brother, pick your 5 stones. Praise the living God. And when the day was very hot for the children of Israel, 2016, we have not come to conclusion how it will be. But the preparation is this. You have to pick your 5 stones. And that 5 stones are the stones to conquer the enemy.
Amen.
Are the stones to conquer poverty.
Amen.
Those are the stones to destroy disappointments.
Amen.
Those are the stones to destroy sickness.
Amen.
Those are the stones to destroy sudden death.
Amen.
Those are the stones to destroy accidents.
Amen.
Those are the stones to destroy occultic kingdom.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
When David was picking these 5 stones, nobody knew what he was doing. Remember the army of Israel, they have surrendered. Saul and all his men, they were tired. They couldn't confront that mighty man called Goliath. Praise the living God. But when David came under the anointing of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit commanded him, pick your 5 stones. For where you are going, these 5 stones shall be stone of destruction of the enemy. Praise the living God. And Goliath, the giant, which have been disturbing your life since you was born, this Goliath has been fighting that you will not succeed. If you are almost at the point of success, it will pull you down again.
Yeah.
Praise the living God. But this year, 2016, that stone will destroy that Goliath in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That will never be pulled down.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
Our message is spiritual. I want you to understand the spiritual points of that message. The importance of that 5 stones. Because David was born in a different generation and in a different era. And when they prophesied of Christ, was a total different generation. And when Christ now came, it was a different generation. Praise the living God.
Amen.
But this 5 stone keep living. This 5 stone will never die. And Christ is that 5 stone. The 5 stone that destroyed the enemy of the Israel. And Israel, they conquered. Be a conqueror in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our brother has given account of his accidents. 4 consecutive accidents. Praise the living God. Those people that are causing those accidents, my ministration is more of spiritual ministration, not what I learned from school. I didn't go to any school. I didn't go to any theological school. But when I lie down, they come and teach me what to say. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Those people that are responsible of that accident, it is time for you to strike them down.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Are there occultic people here? The mercy that we are giving to them is for them to repent as they are hearing this message.
Amen.
Is there an occultic man or occultic woman? Remember that the children of God are under anointing. Because of they are under anointing. And the word of God said in the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 15, for the reason of this anointing, the occultic people shall gather. Their gathering is not of God. Because their gathering is not of God, they shall surely be scattered. And in verse 16, it says, listen, I have created the smith, and I have created the destroyer. And verse 17, it says, No weapon of the enemies formed against a child of God that shall ever prosper. No weapon of the enemies formed against Melvis that we ever prosper. No weapon of the enemy formed against Modestus that we ever prosper. The enemy of this occultic people must be destroyed under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ. As they are hearing, God has given you the grace to survive 2015 under your occultic schedules and occultic plans and attacks. But thanks be to God Almighty. According to the book of 1 Corinthians 15 verse 57, he says, thanks be to God Almighty, who has given the children of God victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Our message is spiritual. Yeah. And now let us consider these five stones. Where these five stones has worked in the past. Remember the first stone that the Bible is telling us about is called Wonderful. When you release this stone, wonderful things will start to happen.
Amen.
Those impossibilities of your life will start to be possible. Those that are closed doors of the past, those closed doors shall be open. Because this mighty stone, if you go in the book of Micah chapter 2, verse 12, it says, the breaker will go before you. That breaker is this mighty stone. It's our Lord God of hosts, who will shatter and scatter every mountain of your barrier in life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our children must succeed and survive in a wonderful way.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
We don't need poor people. If all of us are poor, who will pay for the house rent of this place?
Amen.
Who will come and pick us up when we need ride? If the occultic people want to attack people that manage to buy push me, I push you car, when they buy jet or when they buy real car, what will happen? Occultism is not of God. We are talking of the name of Jesus Christ that has been given unto mankind for salvation and blessings. And Jesus, there is nothing occultic that is being attacked to the name of Jesus Christ. But let me tell you one thing. Early this year, I was here. I think the first service here, first Sunday of this year, January, I was here and the Spirit of God said, preach against occultism. I preach against occultism. I preach against gods that are no God. I mentioned so many names of gods. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And when I went home, they came to take away my life. Praise the living God.
Amen.
But because of I'm under the anointing of the Holy Spirit, they were unable to fulfill it. And they struggled, they started running. Who is chasing them is that stone. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I want that stone to start chasing them in your life and in your case in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That was why I keep standing, preaching against this occultism. I have defeated them once, twice, thrice, and so many times under the help of the Holy Spirit. And therefore, it is your turn to defeat them.
Amen.
When they invoke those accidents, we are praying back to sender by the Holy Ghost.
Fire.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Occultism is not of God. Jesus is not an occultic God. Angel Michael is not occultic. Angel Gabriel is not occultic. Angel Raphael is not occultic. None of the angels of God are occultic. Heavenly powers, there is no occultism there. Therefore, we are preaching against occultism. And if you continue doing it, you must pay with your own head. Are you a man or a woman? I don't care what you are. And I don't care how many gods that are backing you. But I know the power that I stood upon him. Praise the living God.
Amen.
That power, we call him wonderful.
Yeah.
Tell your brother or your sister, let wonderful fight your battle in Jesus' name. Please, if you have your Bible, turn with me to the book of Judges. Let us see this name, wonderful, what it performed. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The book of Judges chapter 13 from verse 19. If you are there, say amen. Judges chapter 13, verse 19. Are we there? And he says, so Manoah took a kid with a meat offering and offered it upon a rock unto the Lord, and the angel of the Lord did wondrously. Praise the living God. When the children of Israel are in the situation that you are facing today, there was no hope for them. They were under captive. And they have been there for 40 years. Praise the living God. For full 40 years, they have been suffering. from the power of these occultic people, from the power of their adversaries. But when time comes, this wonderful came from the heavenly places. In some version, he called it wonderful. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And this wonderful now predicted, as I'm telling you the word of God, he came to Manoah, to Manoah's wife, and he told her, your wife will conceive. A woman who has been barren, she was unable to conceive. Since she was married, she have no child. But this power that they call wonderful came from the heavenly places and said unto her, woman, you will conceive. And when you conceive, a woman who has lost hope, when you conceive, the name shall be called Samson. Praise the living God. The name of this child shall be called Samson, because the power has given unto him to deliver the people of God from their enemies. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
And now the husband was worried. Then I said, please tell us your name. When such a thing happened, so that we will know how to locate you. Praise the living God.
Amen.
But they never knew they were talking to the angels of God. And the power of God that is called wonderful called her and said, my name is wonderful. No need of her, it will happen. They now persuaded the angel of God. They persuaded Christ, even not the angel. Please, come and even eat. Praise the living God.
Amen.
He refused to eat anything. He said, offer it this way. He offered this way. And fire descended from heaven and consumed that sacrifice. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
That was why the name of God is called wonderful. Because in that situation, you have been hopeless. A wonderful thing will happen in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Even if the whole of this world is collapsing, because you believe in the name of the Most High God,
yeah,
your situation and your case will be a different thing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
How it will happen, I don't know. Don't ask me when or how will it happen. But all I know is that it will surely happen in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And that name, wonderful, will come into your life and we start to tell people what God has done in your life. Because the book of Daniel chapter 11 verse 3 says, for those that know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. Praise the living God. And when Samson was born, he grew in the power of the Holy Spirit and he started destroying the enemies as a single man. Praise the living God. And he liberated his people from the captivity of the enemies. And you are all wonderful when it comes. You will be liberated from your ancestral curses, from the demonic bondages,
Amen,
from bondages of occultic world,
Amen,
from bondages of evil people.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
But one more thing is important for us to realize that fact. One of the facts is this. The angels of God doesn't descend the way we see them. The angel of God will never be visible to you. You can never see Peter as the angel of God. This is Peter. But you see him as a human being, Peter. But inwardly, the angel of God is in him. Praise the living God. Because Samson is a word from God and it's a power. So that power that was in him started doing those great things. Praise the living God. So when you are attacking Peter, you are not attacking him as a man, but you are attacking the angel of God. Praise the living God. So the people that we are invoking accident to kill, remember that it's God you are doing those things to. Praise the living God.
Amen.
What is their crime? Even if these people have crime, but Jesus said we have to forgive. But I see no crime even. Praise the living God.
Amen.
If you have signed contract with a occultic world that you doesn't want to change, please break that contract. And if you fail to break it, God will break you and that contract in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And the second name of our God is called Counselor. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
If you have your Bible, please turn with me to the book of Revelation. The book of Revelation chapter 3, verse 18. Revelation chapter 3, verse 18. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
I read. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that thou may be rich, and white raiment, that thou may be clothed, and that the shame of thy nakedness do not appear, and anoint thy eyes with eyes live, that thou mayest see. Praise thy living God. When Christ was sending his angel to the church of Philadelphia, and the angel said to them, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that great counselor, who we call counselor in the book of Isaiah chapter 9, he was counseling the church of Philadelphia. He said, please, buy the gold that was properly tried in that furnace. A gold that will have guarantee that this is not a fake stone. Praise the living God. When you buy this gold, it will make you to be rich. When you take the word of God and repent from occultism, it will make you to be rich.
Amen.
And we will have more life. Praise the living God.
Amen.
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 This occultism, it might be Dixon. It might be you. So when it comes to you and you are occultic, don't attack the message at all. Just quietly, within yourself, start to ask God for mercy and forgiveness.
Amen.
Praise the living God. Amen. And Christ was the one saying, talking to his church, buy of this gold. When you buy of this gold, you will never be poor anymore, but you will be rich. Let me tell you, he's not talking about this earth. The things of this earth comes and go. Praise the living God. But he's telling you about a place where you will be forever. No sickness and no troubles. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And secondly, he said he's advising us, now go and get a better white coat. A better white garment that will not be naked. Praise the living God. When they refer to Brother Mill as a stupid boy, he's naked. Nobody will like to associate with him. But we can still greet him as our brother or somebody we know. And all about him will be of evil. That is not of Christ. Now Christ is talking to I and you. Take up the coat of Christ. The coat of righteousness. Tell me what is so difficult to do what is good. Nothing so difficult. The strength that it takes you to do what is evil is more greater than the strength it takes you to do what is good. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When I want to kill Mill, I will start planning on how to poison him. Probably I will go to get any destructive object against him, which I have spent money. I have spent my time in planning those evil. But when I want to help Mill for a job, it takes me just a phone call. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Which is far easier to do what is good than doing what is evil. And the evil that we have been doing, what is the success of those evil? Have our accounts been filled up because we are doing evil? Have you received a special honor because you are doing evil? Praise the living God.
Yeah, yeah.
We are talking about the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And at the same time as we are talking about the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, we are talking about the names of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We are talking about his qualities. We are talking about the advice that he gave to us. Revelation was written after the death of Jesus. After he has ascended to heaven, he still speaks unto his holy angels. Go and speak to my churches. This is what they need to apply in their life for them to come to where I am. Remember in the book of John chapter 14, verse 6, chapter 17, he says, in my Father's home, there are many mansions. As I'm going to prepare your own mansion. Wherever I am, that is where you will be. And if it is not so, I will not tell you. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Christ did not tell lie for one day, all the days of his life on earth. And I believe he's not telling anybody lie. Praise the living God.
Amen.
So as he's asking you to close yourself so that you will not be ashamed. And he said, use the anointing oil to rub it on your eyes so that you will start seeing good things. And good things will start seeing you. When you use the anointing oil of our Lord Jesus Christ, which comes from the side of his lips, where he was tapped, that anointing oil is what we call the blood of Jesus. When you use it, your life will be changed and transformed. Everything you are doing will be a successful one. Praise the living God. But still remember in the book of Isaiah chapter 9 verse 9, he says, but my people refuse to take my word. Praise the living God. The children of God need to take in the word of God. When we take in the word of God, there will be a great transformation in our life. Amen?
Amen.
And now let us go to the third name. If you have your name, your Bible, please turn to the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 49, verse 24. Genesis chapter 49, verse 24. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
I read. But his bow abode in strength, and the arms of his hands were made strong by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Now, the mighty God of Jacob. Now, when we go further, it says, from thence is the shepherd, the stone of Israel. Praise the living God.
Amen.
I want you to understand the spiritual link, the significance. When we go to the book of Isaiah 2, let's go back to Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 8. If you have it, please read from your own scripture. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 8. Yes, Isaiah 9, verse 8.
The Lord sent the word into Jacob and had lifted upon Israel.
Praise the living God. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to understand the two links. They called God, Jacob called him mighty God. Praise the living God. In the book of Genesis, he called him mighty God. And in the book of Isaiah chapter 9, verse 8, he says now, the word of God went into Jacob. The word of our most high God went into Jacob. And those words came out of Jacob and became what?
Israel.
God bless you. And now Israel, how many tribes are there? Is that not the 12 sons of Jacob? Now understand that Jacob is not a common man. But it's a word from above. And the same word of God now went into him. And he called that God the mighty God. And then Isaiah said now, this word came into him. And we start seeing the nation of Israel. And now, our Lord Jesus Christ, how many disciples is he having? Praise the living God.
Amen.
You testify all this yourselves.
Amen.
So this mighty God is the God that will send his word into you. And all your problem will be solved.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
In the difficulties and journey of Jacob, he went up and down. He was hopeless sometime. Remember that his uncle started cheating him. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The uncle of Jacob, Laban, started cheating him. He said, you will take white goats. Jacob said, okay, I will take white goats. When white goats start multiplying, he said, no, I said white and black. He will claim all of them. And when white and black start coming many, he said, no, I said only black. Praise the living God. And he called him and said, come and there, if you start finish, point the daughter you need. And Jacob points who? Which of the daughter does Jacob point?
Rachel.
Praise the living God. Jacob said, Rachel is what I need. He now asked Jacob, keep serving. After 7 years, 419 did not start in our generation. Praise the living God. After full 7 years, he went and bring the one that is having eye problem, Leah, the senior one, and gave to Jacob. And he now told Jacob, our culture, we cannot give the younger one and leave the older one. But he did not explain it from the beginning. Praise the living God. This message today has a spiritual link. Sometimes you go to work. They tell you 1 hour. 1 hour, 5,000. And at the end of the month, they calculated it is not up to 2,000 per hour. Praise the living God. You will start crying. You will say God has abandoned you. I want you to take in that strength in you. Jacob took in the strength of the mighty God. And when they cheated him, they said, we are giving you Leah instead of Rachel. He agreed. Praise the living God.
Amen.
As some of you are looking at me, nodding your heads, don't go and take a two wife.
Yeah.
And he endured and persevered for another 7 years. When I was going through Kakao ID captions, one of the brothers wrote his own. Time heals everything. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
He said, time heals everything. Don't be too in a haste. The book of Psalms chapter 40 verse 1 said, I call unto the Lord and wait for him patiently. Praise the living God. And after full 7 years, they gave him Leah, making it 2 wives. He served for 14 years. Praise the living God. The generation of Laban and the generation of Jacob, which one is known? Praise the living God. In the book of Genesis chapter 32, Jacob defeated the angel of God. I will never let you go unless you bless me. Praise the living God. When the power of God comes into you, all they have stolen from you will come back.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are talking about the mighty God. He is the God who will fight this battle for you. That was why in the book of Isaiah 43, in verse 18, he said, remember not the things of the past. The former things, never put them into consideration. For I'm about to do a new thing in your life. Let God start doing new things in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All you have lost in the past, the prophet was giving testimony. When I was looking at him, it's like shedding tears. I'm seeing everything passed away. Praise the living God. Some other brother here, they didn't intend to come to Korea. No. But when the situation changed, the other one said, I keep seeing all my goods being burned. Praise the living God. But the word of God is that God is about to do new thing in your life.
Amen.
The old thing must pass away and before the new thing will come in.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
And after they have finished cheating Jacob, what happened? When Jacob now decided, okay, let me pack my children and my wife and start going. Mr. Laban starts chasing him. That Mr. Laban is an occultic man. That occultic man here. But the Lord called Laban. Never you touch my anointed. If you touch him, I will destroy you.
Amen.
May the warning of the Most High God go to the occultic kingdom in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If you are scared, when will you reach? Then you stop being scared of them. Be strong and take the armor of God.
Yeah.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 12 says, chapter 6, verse 12, it says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities. Wickedness in higher places. Those occultic people are wicked people in higher places. But the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4 says, the weapon of our warfare is strong in God Almighty. In pulling down those occultic people, when they want to fly, you put them down. Praise the living God. I pray that they will repent. Time is going out, passing away fast. If you doesn't repent from that occultism, Christ Jesus will jam you. And will never exist again. But consider the evil things we are doing. It's just for the meantime. When I go to my country, I know that occultism may not come there. Even if I have family members that are occultic members, I will destroy all of them one after the other. There is power in this mighty God. This power in the mighty God of Jacob. That was what Jacob used. And he conquered Esau, his brother. He conquered Laban, his in-law. And he went home with all his property. Go home with your properties in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Some people complain. I have been working. I'm not seeing that money. It happened to me as well. That was how I know what you are complaining of. But the power of this mighty God, any money that goes into your hand that is your labor shall stay in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
The children of God have suffered so much. But this is time that God will fight their battle for them.
Amen.
Because when Moses was panicking with the children of Israel, in Exodus 14, verse 13 and 14, the Almighty God of Jacob called him and said, panic not no more, O Moses. I will fight your battle. You will only stand and be a spectator. Just to watch how I will destroy them. And what happened? The Pharaoh and his stupid soldiers keep on chasing. Because this occultic people has no repentance. Praise the living God. And time come in the midst of this sea. And God sink them. May God sink all of them that are chasing you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
And the fourth name is called Everlasting Father. Praise the living God. If you have your Bible, please quickly turn with me to the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 21, verse 33. Genesis chapter 21, verse 33. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
I read. And Abraham planted a grove in Beersheba and called there on the name of the Lord, the everlasting God. God is our Father. Is it not so?
Yes.
Your difficulties has not been up to the difficulties of Abraham. You know, some of us that have beautiful wives, they go and hide their wife and come. Amen? Why they are hiding their wife is so that their wife will not turn to another person's wife. Praise the living God. In the case of Abraham, when he was moving with our mother Sarah, an occultic king, Abimelech, he saw them and decided to hijack Sarah. And he took the wife of Abraham. If you read it from verse 1 to end, Genesis 20 and 21, you will see this story. He hijacked a married woman and went into his palace that they should keep her for him. Praise the living God. And at night, God went to this king and knocked for him and cautioned him. I'm warning you, my warning is this. If you near that woman, I will destroy all your land. None of the women in your land will ever conceive. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
And when the tension was much, king started begging. May those occultic people that are voking this their nonsense start begging in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Because the power that attacked that king will be attacking them.
Yeah.
They will never have rest. As we are having 4 days to go, I have been in prayer. And God has been doing great and wonderful things.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
Those occultic people must go and pay. They must go and pay homage and damages that they have caused for people. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
And Abraham called God everlasting God, everlasting Father. Now in Hebrew, he called him Jehovah Oram. And Jacob called him Jehovah Abiel. Praise the living God. When we are praying, I'm using the name of God. What I'm using is the name of the Most High God. Because when we turn the name of Ngozi to English language, it doesn't sound very sweet. And the English language will not get exactly the meaning. Praise the living God.
Amen.
When you say Ngozik, who will tell me what it is in English? Nobody.
Dress in grace.
These people, anyway, let me take it. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And let us go to the last name of this our Lord Jesus Christ. If you have your Bible, please turn with me to the book of Hebrews chapter 7. Hebrews chapter 7 verse 2. If you are there, please read for us. Hebrews chapter 7.
To whom also Abraham gave the tenth part of all, first being by interpretation, king of righteousness, and after that also king of Salem, which is king of peace.
Praise the living God. God bless you, dear brother. And Abraham called this our God again. The King of Peace. But remember that the book of Isaiah called him Prince of Peace. These are the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When you need peace in your life, maybe you have not had a better peace in your life. Since you was born, there is no peace. That peace is called Jehovah Shalom. In the book of Judges chapter 6 verse 20.